It's left Benoit battered and bloody tonight. They'll get it on deep in the heart of Texas next Monday night in Austin. Six-man tag team match here tonight, or will it be a handicap match?
Well, I just heard it announced as a six-man match, but Triple H said he's not going to be here. He's not here. You calling him a liar still, JR?
They were calling him a liar to start with. I just said Eric Bischoff brought up a very good point.
Introducing his tag team partners, first from Charlottesville, Virginia, weighing in at 225 pounds, Maven.
Triple H is not called the Cerebral Assassin or nothing. This may be an elaborate setup for all we know.
Oh, see? Well, that's calling him a liar.
Folks, next week, as we said, in Austin, Texas, it's going to be big. Everything's big in Texas. Edge and against his former tag team partner, Chris Benoit, will it end like it ended tonight with Benoit battered and bloody? We'll find out in Austin Monday.
Tell you something, Maven looking.
And from St. Louis, Missouri, weighing in at 255 pounds, Randy Orton.
Maven looking good tonight, and so is Randy Orton. His entire team looks like they're ready, JR.
Almost a preview of the Survivor Series elimination matchup. That Maven, Benoit, Jericho, and Orton will be a forming one team. And what an ovation for Randy Orton.
The only thing you got to remember that Survivor Series match, Nate, Ric Flair was left out
on purpose.
Yeah. Well, Raw is brought to you by WWE SmackDown versus Raw. Two worlds collide on PlayStation 2. That's going to be in stores tomorrow.
At the moment here, but Batista seemed to be a little bit overzealous, knowing that it could be Batista and Flair without Triple H against three men. I don't know.
Well, Batista is the future of Evolution. He fears no man. He fears no three men.
Triple H said earlier tonight from a remote location that last week's locker room revolt was a violent display of jealousy and envy by the other Raw superstar.
I couldn't have said it better myself. That's exactly what it was. It's about time these superstars around here in the WWE started paying Triple H the respect that he deserves, JR. Libby, why are you shaking your head? You not thinking Triple H deserves respect?
I'm not saying that. I think you reap what you sow, as I said earlier. Triple H said the attitude's better changed now. If Triple H is not here tonight, as he said he would not be, then he says he's going to be in Austin next Monday. But Eric Bischoff brought up a great point, a general manager.
What?
That Triple H may have just orchestrated an opportunity to get some retribution for last week's inmates running the asylum. Randy Orton and Batista starting out this, what appears to be, at this point in time, a handicap match.
Yeah, look at Randy Orton. He's a former member of Evolution. Because he got led down the wrong path. I don't know what went wrong in his mind.
And a Batista, the animal of Evolution, reversing Randy Orton into the corner here. Batista overpowers.
Oh man.
Virtually anybody he gets in the ring with. And Randy Orton, so resourceful.
Look at this move. Look at this move.
Turn to the roll up and on near fall already here in the early going.
See, this match could have been over already, JR. That was close. And I just don't think Triple H, if he were here, he wouldn't have put Batista and Nate out here at this disadvantage.
Cut forward by Randy Orton, hammering Batista down the outside. Here live tonight on Monday Night Raw as we continue the countdown to the 18th annual Survivor Series.
And 18th annual. Wow.
Amazing, isn't it?
Come on.
How time flies.
Cleveland is going to be rocking.
Boom! And Batista getting set a little early there. A knockdown. Boy, this teases him. He is a physical specimen, and here comes the dirtiest player in the game.
What do you think's coming up here?
I think we got our answer.
I love the sound of that.
Flash on flash. And Orton turned the table.
Fist on
nature ball.
Isn't that right?
Clinch fist by Randy Orton. Knock it down, the 16th time former World's Heavyweight Champion.
Orton having to resort to clinched fist. Oh, no!
Right back, body drop. And Flair, you can hear he's screaming in pain from those.
Yeah, I'm telling you. Triple H wouldn't let these guys go it alone.
Oh, power slam by Randy Orton again, focusing on the back of the Nature Boy, Ric Flair.
And he's also focusing on Batista there.
And we have seen a new attitude tonight by Raw General Manager Eric Bischoff.
Do you really think that before this night is over, Randy Orton may be focusing on Triple H? Do you really believe that, JR?
I quite frankly don't know what to believe anymore. The inmates running the asylum and what a top. How can you predict what's going to happen here live on Monday night? You can't.
Oh, you're talking about inmates running the asylum. Look out. How important does that make Survivor Series, that match at Survivor Series? The winning team, each member of that winning team is going to get to completely run Raw for a week.
Yeah, because Eric Bischoff says he's going to take a month's vacation after the Survivor Series.
Oh, no, look out. Look out, Nate.
Don't let pick up. Jericho may be looking for the walls of Jericho here. And Flair in a bad way.
You better do something, Batista.
Here it comes. And, oh, look at this.
Oh. See the strength in numbers?
Might makes right, as the game said last week. And there's some mighty determined men in Jericho, Maven, and Randy Orton.
This locker room revolt, I'm telling you.
And Eric Bischoff said he was going to let it ride.
Oh, that's a bad thing, a real bad thing.
And look at this. Oh, man, what strength. That's a great strength by Randy Orton. Vertical suplexing Ric Flair from the outside in. And Orton, the former member of Evolution.
Well, I'm sure it's hard for Ric Flair to focus on anything after the news he found out earlier tonight that he was left out of that match at Survivor Series. I've never seen such a look on Ric Flair. Look at this.
Maven with a drop kick off the top. Maven looks into awesome condition. Maven has never looked better. Look at Maven. He wants a piece of Batista.
And look at Orton stepping up there, making 2-on-1. And now Jericho from behind. Poor Nate.
Let me tell you, Evolution, this is evolutionary tactics. The mismatches, the 3-on-2s. Slobber knocking shots by Jericho on Flair's chest.
Flair's being subjected to this. He usually dishes this out. Tonight he's having to take it. In your own corner, Orton.
He's having a hard time here controlling these men. And now look,
choking. Look at this.
Maven is using the tag team rope.
Who does he think he is? The dirtiest player in the game?
Maybe Maven's been paying attention.
Certainly the dirtiest player in this match. Come on, Nate.
Flair taking that header. I can't believe Eric Bischoff said earlier that Triple H said, without him, Raw is nothing. But Bischoff retorted by saying, without the World Championship, Triple H is nothing.
These fans here in Peoria actually cheering poor Nature Boy, as you said, taking that header.
Oh, the
look at this. Cheap shot.
The referee didn't see it. He was detained there with Batista. And Flair getting a dose of his own medicine. I think that's about page 5 of the Flair playbook.
Oh, no.
Oh, God. And Jericho, Orton, and Maven having their way with Flair and Batista. Oh, the flick of the eyes. And shot in the back of the head. Here comes Batista, and Batista's got it. He's going to make sure he gets attacked.
He's certainly taking matters into his own hands.
Exactly.